Google Meets gets additional engagement and safety features. WhatsApp releases a new announcement about its terms and privacy policy. Facebook's virtual reality device Oculus now has multi-user account. All this and much more coming up in this week's edition of the Connected Church News. And not just that, at the end in our bonus segment, I'm going to talk about two important industry reports that were released last week that you don't want to miss. Welcome, I'm Nachi Lazarus. This is a show that brings you the top 5 digital and social media news each week in less than 5 minutes. Let's get started. Our first big news is from Google. Last week, Google Meet team released new engagement and safety features within the tool. And today, most of us spend our time online between Zoom and Google Meet kind of tools with virtual classrooms and online meetings and so on. So this news item will be something that might need your attention because these features are very interesting. There are three parts of the announcement that I wanted to highlight to you. First is the safety features where you can mute people, and there are lots of other small safety features that makes a big difference, especially if you're handling a classroom or a big group of people and you want it to be highly moderated. Very interesting, useful features. Definitely check it out. The second part of the announcement is about mobile. Now, most of these features are coming to mobile devices, the apps inside your mobile phone and iPad, which makes it extremely convenient because the more control you have on mobile devices, the better it is. Today, many other conference apps lack lot of features inside mobile devices. So Google is trying to bridge that gap. And the final piece is if you use Google Classroom, now this Google Meet and Classroom seem to be working very tightly with each other. So I will link to all these details in the show notes. Definitely check it out. Have you subscribed to our channel yet? If you've not done so, subscribe so that you can stay on top of all the weekly digital and social media news every single week. Thank you for subscribing. Also hit that notification bell icon so that you can always be updated. Thank you. Now let's get back to our news item. Our next news is from WhatsApp. Last week, WhatsApp made an additional announcement about its upcoming terms and privacy policy updates. The deadline for accepting these new terms was February, but then they moved it to May. So I think they're trying to warm people up towards the point where they have to accept these terms, and they are starting to clarify better because and it's very interesting to see in this announcement how WhatsApp takes this, the way this announcement came out, very seriously. And they're saying we could have done a better job. Literally it says we reflected on what we could have done better here. That's what WhatsApp says. And they are talking about giving more information so that you understand what these policies are. And they also stress on the fact that these privacy policies are around business transactions and personal messages. The announcement says personal messages will always be end-to-end encrypted, so WhatsApp can't read or listen to them. So this announcement also has links clarifying WhatsApp's position. I will link to all of it in the show notes. Definitely check it out. Our next news is from Facebook. Last week, Facebook's Oculus team, the virtual reality headset Oculus team, released details about new multi-user account features and also app sharing features. Earlier, if you had an Oculus device, you can only add one Facebook account to it. Now you can add multi-user accounts and also share the apps that you've already purchased. Virtual reality is in its nascent stage, but it's a very interesting space, especially something you and me as ministries and nonprofits have to pay attention to because it's starting to grow and people are starting to have this new experience in the virtual world. Virtual experience, new interesting virtual experiences are the one that bring people together, and virtual reality literally brings people together in a virtual space. So something that you need to watch out for. Do check out this news. Our next important news is from YouTube. YouTube released new comparative tools inside analytics. So last week they talked about how you can use these tools. One is called dot plots, which sounds very interesting to me because what it does is it helps you take all your videos that you posted in a certain period of time, put them in one graph as dots, and you can select how did all these videos do in the first 24 hours after they were released. How did all these videos do in the first 7 days after they released? You know, things like that. And then you suddenly start seeing this graph with all these dots, and you can see how your audience are responding to certain type of content and what content does not work very well. And then suddenly you get clarity on what content you need to be focusing on, what type of content you need to produce that's resonating with your audience. So I think these two, and they also have a comparative tool which you can place two videos side by side. So quite useful tools. I definitely recommend you pass this on to your social media team so that they can analyze and come up with ideas for content. Our final news this week is from Twitter. Twitter starts testing audio direct messages, audio clips that can be sent via direct messages in three markets officially, Japan, Brazil, and India. The news of these audio-based messages has been floating around since August, and now Twitter has officially announced that they have started testing it in these three markets, and looks like based on the test they will roll out to a wider audience. Those are the top five news items we have for you this week, but stay with me because we've got a bonus section coming up where I'm going to talk to you about two industry reports. In our bonus section, I wanted to bring your attention to two important industry reports that were released last week. One is for younger audience. So if you are a ministry or a nonprofit that works with younger people, then the first report from Snapchat, which is called a Snapchat Generation Report, that talks about Gen Z and their changing trends and their mindset, could be something that's important. It's very interesting to see how the new generation is consuming content. And as a ministry, it's important for us to be prepared to minister to them in a relevant way. So definitely look at these news items and see if you can glean some important insights from these reports. For example, it says this generation is more interested in photos as a type, or an image as a type of content, and they are very keen to consume that type of a content. Just one point from that, but definitely check out the other details. These reports are available publicly. I will link to all of them in the show notes so you can download and talk to your team and try to fine-tune your strategy based on that. The second report is from Facebook, and it's the second volume of this report called State of Small Business Report. The significance of this report is it talks about what happened in 2020 and how that has changed the way small businesses work. And for you as a ministry or nonprofit, this is an indication of what's happening in our society and in our economy, because this impacts the lives of the people that we minister to. So it's good for you to see what's happening and also fine-tune your strategy, your online strategy, based on some of the learnings from these reports. The links to these two reports are in the description or in the show notes, so you can have a look at it or pass it on to your social media team. Thank you, and I'll see you next week. But in the meantime, you can continue learning by visiting this playlist that has questions and answers from leaders like you, leaders of nonprofit churches and ministries, about digital and social media. Do check it out. You might find a question that you've always had in your mind and how it's answered.